It's probably best for me to start out to say we have two rules. Okay, only two. Rule number one, you can ask questions anytime you want to. I don't have a speech. What I came to do was talk with you, and I have much more fun when I have an opportunity to answer your questions. So I brought some slides. We can go through one or none. You've already seen the first one, so we can stay on that one forever. We won't. But we'll go through those. So that's rule number one. You can ask questions anytime you want to. And the second rule is there are no dumb questions. You may sit there and think, I really want to know this, but you may be embarrassed to ask because you think it's a dumb question. It doesn't exist. There is no dumb question. I'm known around my headquarters for asking the dumb questions. All right, test time, since nobody had any questions for me. Okay, tell me one of Newton's laws of motion. For every action there is an equal and opposite reaction. That's right. And as a matter of fact,
thank you.
Fantastic. Hold on, we're not. That's one, but we're not done yet because I want two more. And I'm picky, so I want to in specifically. For every action, there's an equal and opposite reaction. When we're in space floating around like this, if I take my finger, like I'm about to do there, and I push on a button, and I don't have my feet in a stirrup, or I'm not holding on to something, guess what happens to my body? It goes the opposite way. So you learn very quickly in space. You're sitting there, and you're trying to type on a keyboard, and you press on the keyboard, and all of a sudden, you're going backwards. So that action causes an equal and opposite reaction. Two more. What about a body at rest?
If something is in motion, it stays
in motion. Ah! Great. And what's the other one? What's the other side of it? For a body at rest?
It stays at rest.
Hey, you got it. What's your name?
Hello.
Sign him up. Future astronaut. A body at rest tends to stay at rest unless otherwise acted upon by an outside force. Remember that? Huh? Okay. And a body in motion tends to stay in motion unless otherwise acted upon by an outside force. We're just kind of dangling. I'm dangling with my back up against the ceiling of the shuttle because I got up there and I balanced myself and then I took my hands away and I just stayed there. If I move my head, my body will tend to drift in the direction that I move my head.
We're not going to destroy Mars,
too. Oh, how do we know that we're not going to destroy Mars the way that we're working on destroying Earth's environment? Is that the crux of your question? We don't know. And what we're trying to do is be smart about how we approach other planets. When we get ready to go to another planet today, we have a program we call Planetary Protection. And we really look at making sure that we don't take germs and other kinds of things to another planet. When Curiosity went, I mean, Curiosity was scrubbed and baked and all kinds of stuff. It was about as clean as we could possibly make it. So we could not detect any germs or any kinds of anything on Curiosity. And that's just the way we're going to have to approach all of our planetary missions as we go out. That's a good story. Because the good story in that is that from the vantage point of space, where some of you are going to live and work one of these days, there are no differences down here. There are no borders. It's just all one big planet. You learn that the oceans of the world, we give them all different names, they're all one ocean. We're on a water planet. We float on a planet that is about four-fifths water, and it's one giant ocean with little bodies of water that stick up in that giant ocean every once in a while. The big bodies we call continents, the little bitty ones we call islands, but they're all sticking up in this big old ocean, and we just call it by different names depending on where it is. Is there a question over there? Who's got the mic?
Er hat uns einen guten Einblick in das NASA-Leben geschafft, und ich finde auch, er sollte wieder mal herkommen.
Wie fandest du denn das Event?
Ich fand es sehr informativ und es war eine schöne Atmosphäre. Ich fand, dass er sehr offen war und nicht abgehoben, wie man es vielleicht von einem Astronauten erwarten würde.
And he said, well, I don't get it. He said, you know, all I've heard about you is all you've done is care for other people. You have never cried out in pain. You've never asked for help. You've never asked for anything for you. It's always been other people. Why? Why do you do that? And he said, Nikosi looked up at him and he smiled and he said, you do all you can with what you have in the time that you have in the place that you are. That's the message I'll leave you all with. You know, we've had a lot of fun today, I hope. I hope you have. Do all that you can with what you have in whatever time you have on this planet, wherever you happen to be. You all are really good. You're blessed to be here. So God bless all of you. And thanks so much for letting me spend time with you.